Good afternoon. Thank you for being here today. My name is Ruth Smith. I'm the Chief Communications Officer for New Hanover County. Today, we will have an opportunity to provide you with some insight. We will have several speakers and then open the press conference for question and answer from only the media. And we ask that you identify yourself prior to speaking and asking your question. Please let us know who you would like your question directed to when you do speak. Now I'd like to turn this over to our chairman of the New Hanover County Board of Commissioners, Woody White.
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the 220,000 citizens of New Hanover County and my fellow county commissioners, Skip Watkins, Rob Zappel, Jonathan Barfield, and Patricia Cusick, I'd like to thank you all for being here. Today, I'm joined up here at the podium by the Secretary of North Carolina Department of Environmental Quality, Mr. Michael Regan, by the Deputy Secretary of the Department of Health and Human Services, Mr. Chris Benson, the Mayor of the City of Wilmington. I will make a brief comment and share with you a few things, as much as I can, as to what we've just learned. Then I will turn the podium over to these gentlemen to make statements. Subsequently, we'll try to answer any questions that you have. Moments ago, a meeting with Chemours Company took place just across the hall. The Chemours Company is a chemical company that began formal operations 23 months ago in July of 2015. It was a spinoff of DuPont. It operates a 2,200-acre fluorinated chemicals manufacturing plant in the northwestern portion of Bladen County, North Carolina, situated 71 miles upstream from the city of Wilmington on the Cape Fear River. It's presently seeking a renewal of its permit to allow up to 26 million gallons of water per day withdrawn from the Cape Fear River to conduct manufacturing processes, presumably treating it pursuant to a state permit, and then discharging it back into the Cape Fear River, where the discharged water flows downstream to our community. 1 week ago today, we all awoke, walked to the ends of our driveway, and began reading an article in the Star News that caused immediate alarm, concern, and fear in our community as to the quality and safety of our drinking water, something fundamental to all civilization. The company offered to meet with local leaders from three counties and the city of Wilmington, health officials, and the secretaries that I've mentioned here today. The meeting convened at 11:30. It lasted 96 minutes. Here are some of the things that we learned. That Chemours intends to continue to discharge Gen X and is permitted to do so. Two, that there has been additional testing done since 2013 and that the analysis from Chemours are forthcoming and will be reviewed and analyzed by our state regulators to determine their accuracy. Three, that Chemours models indicate abatement technology installed in 2013 estimates that it dropped Gen X from 631 parts per trillion to 96 parts per trillion, a statistic that we hope will be confirmed or rebutted by the Department of Environmental Quality as it works to confirm this. Fourth and finally, we have asked that Chemours bring this discharge to 0%. They have not committed to do so as of yet. You all have a lot of questions. I hope we will have answers for you. And at this time, I would like to turn it over to Secretary of the Department of Environmental Quality, Michael Regan.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the state of North Carolina, let me begin by saying we all agree that the protection of the quality of the water we drink is the number one priority. and some of our citizens have concerns about the quality of their water. What I can tell you is based on the best available data from sampling in 2013 and 2014, the Department of Health and Human Services has determined that there was a low health risk associated with the exposure to this compound. Based on their evaluation, we believe that this is a low-risk situation, but we are not resting on that analysis. We must have current data, and we must make sound decisions based on current data. At the governor's direction, the North Carolina Department of Environmental Quality, in consultation with the Department of Health and Human Services, is leading a state investigation regarding the report of the unregulated chemical Gen X in the Cape Fear River. I am seeking answers and solutions to a situation that has prompted understandable concern among the citizens who live and work in Wilmington and the lower Cape Fear region, some of which are my own Department of Environmental Quality regional staff and their families. Although we're searching for more answers, we are taking action immediately. First, we've been in frequent contact with the Environmental Protection Agency. The United States Environmental Protection Agency is the lead agency that determines responsible drinking water standards. They have informed us that they are working to gather more information on Gen X, which is a compound currently not regulated under the Clean Water or Safe Drinking Water Act. EPA has told us that they're committed to supporting the state and public water systems as next steps are determined. And we are asking the United States Environmental Protection Agency to request the records related to all chemical compounds associated with this story. Given the chemical is unregulated, we are also taking a hard look at all options we have as a state within our regulatory and legal authority to reduce and eliminate the discharge of this chemical as it makes its way to the river until the state completes its investigation. We met with the company this morning, and they informed DEQ staff that their engineers are working to assess the waste streams at the facility in Fayetteville. My department is strongly encouraging Chemours to voluntarily identify any measures that can be taken to reduce or eliminate the discharge of the chemical into the river until the state completes its investigation. Now, the company has responded by saying that they believe that they have reduced the chemical by 80% since 2014. We're asking for proof of that, and we're also asking to work with them to achieve the additional 20% reduction. Starting as early as next week, we will begin water collection and testing in the Cape Fear River. We'll be working with a specialized lab in Colorado capable of analyzing the samples. We expect to receive samples, sampling supplies from this specialized laboratory this week, and our staff are prepared to mobilize as soon as we get that equipment. We've developed a sampling plan that will include water testing at the 4 intakes, the 5 water treatment plants, the Cape Fear Public Utilities Authority aquifer storage and recovery well, and a water supply well used by Wrightsville Beach. Chemours has agreed to bear all of the cost of the water collection and testing, not the taxpayers. We will also be setting up a website to share with each and every one of you the information as the agency receives it. I appreciate the partnership of our federal, state, and local counterparts, and I appreciate the cooperation from the company thus far, and we hope that that continues. It is our goal to bring clarity to this situation as soon as possible, and we will be vigilant in doing that. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Mark Benton. I'm the Deputy Secretary for Health Services for the North Carolina Department of Health and Human Services. The department that I work for has had a close collaboration and partnership working with our colleagues at the North Carolina Department of Environmental Quality in protecting the health of our citizens. In addition to being a fellow teammate, we are here today because we were asked to help the Department of Environmental Quality to interpret the health risk associated with this Gen X exposure. I wanted to sort of point out to you that joining me today are actually several staff from the Division of Public Health that have been involved in the effort in working with our colleagues at DEQ, and they are, first of which are two physicians, the first of which is Dr. Zach Moore, who is our state epidemiologist. Also, another physician we brought with us is Dr. Rick Langley, who is a medical consultant in our Division of Public Health. And we also have three other individuals that work in our branch of environmental epidemiology, and all of which those folks are available to answer any detailed questions that you may have about the sort of analysis and the work and the research that we have reviewed to date. Thank you.
I want to thank Chairman White for putting this meeting together with the company. It was a very frank meeting with some very direct questions and answers. Again, I'm going to reiterate what the chairman has said. We are asking for a 100% elimination of Gen X from the Cape Fear River. The company has indicated that they are going to try everything in their power to do that. But in the meantime, I would ask the state, DEQ, the EPA, to suspend that operation until we have some evidence from the company that says that. because this is an unregulated compound that is in our river, we need to know more about it. There is one specific study that we have. There seems to be others that are out there. We don't know. We ask for that information to be shared with us. But I can assure you that all of the elected folks here, all of the people in this room, want to make certain that we have good, clean drinking water. And that's the thing that I am most want the EPA and our Division of Environmental Quality to tell us after the sampling that this water is safe to drink. Thank you very much.
I'm Frank Williams. I'm the chairman of the Brunswick County Board of Commissioners, which means I had to cross the river in question to get here today. And my family has been in Brunswick County and been living along the Cape Fear River and drinking its water for 150 years. So this is something that certainly is of great interest to us. And a week ago, I had never heard of Chemours, and Gen X was a term used to describe people my age. And it's taken on a whole different meaning in the past week. I knew nothing about this chemical, and it came out, to all of you, it came out of left field to us. And wanted to just share a few things. First and foremost, we share the same concerns you do. I drink the water. I drank some of it a little while ago based on what I have seen in terms of the amount of this compound that's in the water. I still felt comfortable taking a sip of it earlier. But we do share your concerns, and we want information and facts, not just theory. So that's something we're really focused on. I want to introduce a few folks from Brunswick County who are here today. The vice chair of our board, Commissioner Randy Thompson, Commissioner Pat Sykes, our county manager, Ann Hardy, our executive director of Health and Human Services, David Stanley, and our health director, Mr. Chris Harrelson, who's in the back. And as you can see, the staff we brought with us were not our utility staff, they were our health staff, because that's the concern that I think everyone has. And I can assure you that our staff is actively engaged in this on a day-to-day level. They know this stuff far better than I can know it, because I am not a scientist and not a health professional. We are engaged in it, and we understand your concerns, and we certainly want to get to the bottom of it. I want to also thank our state leaders for being here today, the secretary and the deputy secretary. That shows a commitment on their part to help us ensure that our water is clean and safe to drink. I do want to thank the company for taking the time to come down here and meet with us today. They do not operate in Brunswick, New Hanover, or Pender counties. They don't have any subject to, they're not subject to any jurisdiction any of us up here from the county level have, so they did take the time to come down. I do think they were very candid and forthright. I thought they were transparent, and I do want to thank them for that, and I want to share a few things that we ask of them in addition to what's already been shared. We ask them to release any and all health and data studies or information they have to the Department of Health and Human Services and also to our local health departments, and they indicated that they would do that. We also ask them to provide us with not just the state, but provide our local officials with updated and ongoing test results from any additional testing that they do, and they seemed amenable to that as well. And last thing I want to say, or next to last thing, is that Brunswick County concurs with what you've heard from New Hanover County and what you've heard from the city of Wilmington. We are asking the company to cease discharging this toxin into our water until we get more answers. At this point, we don't have answers. There's got to be some way they can continue production while eliminating the discharge, so we're asking them to do that. And I do want to say one other thing. This is a very complex issue, and it cannot be explained in 30-second sound bites, and it cannot be explained accurately on social media. So I would encourage you, if you live in Brunswick County and you want to get information, please visit our county website. We're putting everything we know up there, and as we get more information, we will put it there. We're not going to answer questions we don't know the answer to, but if we do know, we will put it there. And please sign up to get email updates so that you can stay informed as we learn additional information. And I do want to turn it over now to Chairman George Brown from Pender County.
As you said, I'm Chairman George Brown from Pender County. Like New Hanover and Brunswick, we're here today because this concerns us, like everybody in this room. We tried to get answers today. We ask a lot of tough questions. I do appreciate the state folks for coming down and helping us with this. New Hanover, Brunswick, City of Wilmington, we agree with everything that's been said thus far. We stand united with them. We would like to see this come to an end. We would like to see the discharge net zero of the Gen X product being put in the river. Folks, we're going to work on this as hard as we can. We're trying to get answers. As the commissioner from Brunswick County just told you, this is a complex issue. It is no way you can answer this question in 2 or 3 minutes. So just bear with us. The information is going to be forthcoming. We're going to be as transparent as we know how to be with this. This concerns all of us, everybody in this room, everybody in Pender County, New Hanover, and Brunswick. And I'd like to thank Commissioner Woody White for his lead on this and for inviting us to have a seat at the table. And I'll be glad to answer any questions later on if anybody has any. Thank you.
Thank you all very much. That concludes our prepared remarks. If there are any questions that members of the media have of anyone up here, Mr. Buckland.
Mr. White, do you know when the CFPUA learned about Gen X being in the water, and time before 7 days ago, why they weren't being told?
It's a very good question, and I hope they will be forthcoming in answering it. I do not know the answer to it.
Okay, well,
he's in the room, and I would ask you pose those questions to him. Any other questions? Yes, sir. What's your name?
Jordan with the Young Turks.
Spoke yesterday. It's nice to see you.
Hey, you too. So this chemical, there was 16 separate notices sent to the EPA years ago saying that there is a great risk to either people or the environment. So why were the permits given to it in the first place? And the second part is, if there's really no regulation on the chemical and no measurable standards that are exact, how do you deduce that it's a low risk? How do you measure that if it's not regulated and there's really no exact measurements?
The last part of your question, I'm going to defer to the Deputy Secretary for Health and Human Services, who can answer it as to the health risk and toxicology analysis and so forth. But the first part of your question revolves around EPA. And one of the things we learned in this meeting a few minutes ago, which came as a surprise, I think, to all of us, and this is a complicated answer, but it's important. The company told us that the EPA order that they have authority to discharge from 2009, that they discharge 0% of Gen X through that authority. So it begs the question, well, how is it getting in the water? That question was posed. And the answer we got was, well, we recapture 100% of it through the EPA authority, but we also down the road have a manufacturing process associated with making vinyl. If I'm getting this wrong, the scientists will correct me, but that's what these two ears heard. And that as a process of making the vinyl, it throws off as a what they termed a, quote, unintended byproduct, Gen X. The follow-up question was posed. Does the unintended byproduct of Gen X have the same exact chemical and molecular composition as the Gen X that EPA says you can't discharge in the water? The answer was yes. A third question was posed. That doesn't make any sense. Can you explain it? And we got about a 20-minute answer about, which I do concur that the company was as forthcoming as I guess they felt they could be, or at least they answered our questions to the point where we stopped asking them. but the takeaway was that the unintended byproduct through the vinyl manufacturing process is not regulated. Now that strange credulity for me to understand how the EPA can regulate Gen X and say, if you're going to pre-manufacture it and distribute it and sell it in frying pans and everything else, you can't put it in the water. But if you make it as a byproduct through making vinyl, it's unregulated and You don't have to do anything. That's a very oversimplified explanation of what we heard. I can't explain it any further or more than what I just did. But it is something that I think gave everyone in that room some pause as to how the present state of federal regulation would allow that.
And is it the EPA's current decision to allow them to continue to manufacture and release it while these reviews and studies are going on?
At the risk of purporting to be an expert on EPA regulations, which I am not, the answer we were given is the EPA does not have authority or jurisdiction over a, quote, unregulated substance. It's regulated on the one side, but not on the other.
And who has control over their permit to distribute?
Again, I'm getting into territory that these gentlemen can answer much better, but the way I understand it, EPA regulates, and only EPA regulates, the 2009 pre-manufacture order that gave this company the authority to use this product. The state allows a permit for water withdrawal and discharge. It does not mention Gen X. It's not required to mention Gen X. There's nothing that addresses Gen X in the state permit because it's a federal jurisdictional question.
There are reports of a meeting taking place between Bernie and the Ann Arbor County Commissioners and representatives from Chemours. Can you confirm this meeting held in private? And if so, what was the purpose of it?
Well, I've never met with Chemours at all, ever. Never shaking anyone's hand from the company. I walked into the room. I insisted that they sit on the side of the wall where the elected officials and the secretaries would be at the table. They did that. We did not introduce ourselves. It goes without saying they knew who we were, we knew who they were. And they made their presentation and answered our questions. The meeting adjourned 96 minutes later, and we walked out. I can only speak for myself, but I don't think any of my other four commissioners has ever met with Chemours either, but they can certainly answer those questions if they have.
Why not?
Yes, sir.
Ben Shockman, Port City Daily. I'm sure we'll get back to whether this crap fell off the left side or the right side of the wheelbarrow at some point, but now that it's come downstream, are there any commercially available filtration systems that can handle Gen X? Anyone in the room?
I do not know the answer to that. I will say the company, we posed the question to the company, can you get to zero, and if so, how quickly? And we got about a 3-minute answer that said, there's one system we're looking at that if the answer is yes, it's gonna take us a month to do it, and we're gonna do it. The other answer was, if that doesn't work, it's gonna take a while. It was not a satisfactory answer, but it was the best answer they gave.
Was there any discussion of personal household filtration systems?
No.
All right. Follow-up question real quick. I heard you serve them tap water.
We did.
Did they drink it? Did they drink it?
They didn't drink it. I didn't see them drink it, but I drank because I was thirsty.
I had asked the Health and Human Services question.
I'm sorry. You're absolutely right.
And thank you for the question. If I remember it correctly, you were asking more about sort of how we came about our analysis of the data that we know to date about Gen X. And so with that, I'm going to ask one of our physician leaders with the Division of Public Health to come over and give you the specifics on what exactly we looked at, what time period that the data was, and what we gleaned from that.
I'm Zach Moore. I'm the state epidemiologist with the Department of Health and Human Services. So I can address that, and Dr. Langley can pick up if there's additional information. Basically, our role is to help understand the human health data that are out there. So we reviewed all the published studies about toxicology and human health effects related to this compound, which are, there's not as many of those studies as there would be for some older and better known compounds. But there are some data available. So we reviewed those with our toxicology staff, and we also reviewed the data from the 2013-14 levels that were present in the Cape Fear River based on the recent publication. So based on the toxicology data that were available, we calculated what we call a health screening level, which is a level below which we don't expect there to be any adverse health effects. And from what we had available to us with published toxicology data, the health screening level that we came up with was about 100 times higher than the levels that were published from based on 2013-14 data. So we don't know whether the data, first of all, that level that we calculated is based on somewhat limited information. We've heard today that the company is going to provide us with more toxicology studies. We're also going to be continuing to talk with EPA toxicologists, looking at all these new data to see if that level needs to be revised or if that's appropriate. We also don't know what the levels of Gen X in the water are today, so all we can comment on is what we calculated as a health screening level and how that compared to what we saw published from 2013 and 14.
One quick follow-up to you. Does it concern you? I mean, DuPont has a history, if you look at the Ohio Valley years ago, where there was health issues with humans related to C8, which is not that different of a compound to Gen X. So does it concern you that a very similar compound, there was demonstrated problems in humans?
Yeah, and that's, you know, we certainly take into account what's known about similar compounds, because as you said, there is a lot more known about these older compounds that have been phased out, and so we can use that to see what might be expected in terms of health effects for the newer ones. But we don't go with suppositions or guesses. We go with published, well-done science that tells us what the actual effects are, health effects. So that's what we're trying to work with. And so I'm encouraged that we heard today we're going to be getting more detailed health information, and we're going to take that back and work with toxicologists and panel of experts to try to make sure that that we're giving as accurate a picture as we can.
So a few days ago when you released a statement that included the line poses a low threat to human health, that was based on the statistics from 2014 and something else from last year?
That was based on the measurements of Gen X in the Cape Fear River from 2013-14 and based on all the toxicology information that we have available right now.
So that's a low risk, but not no risk, right?
Correct. We can't say no risk. Again, there's a lot of, this is a relatively new chemical, so we're not able to say no risk, but we calculated this to be, and this is based on making the assumption that somebody starts as an infant and drinks this water a certain amount every day, so these are over a lifetime of exposure is how we do those calculations.
What about bathing?
We're taking questions from the media.
Any other questions of members of the media? Mr. Buckley.
Secretary Regan, I understand that the investigation has begun. Is the company facing any potential punitive action? Could that result from the investigation?
It's too early to make any kind of statements on that. I think, let me sort of back up a little bit and say that the United States Environmental Protection Agency is the only agency that can list a pollutant. Until a pollutant is listed, we have limited ways in controlling or regulating. So what we have here is a situation where the company is not breaking the law. The pollutant is not listed. Therefore, the permit that they have that the state has issued currently is in compliance. As we begin to look at the reissuance of the permit, what we hope to do is continue to gather information, work with the United States Environmental Protection Agency, and try to think about the path for either listing this pollutant or thinking about ways that we can get concessions for the company to control the discharge at the levels that we've mentioned earlier.
Do we know when that permit is due, the reissuance of the permit?
The permit, I'm sorry.
When are they due to be reissued?
We're evaluating that permit right now.
Okay. I mean, I'm just wondering, is there an expiration date for the one they've got?
Sure, the expiration date of that permit was, I believe, in October of 2016. And typically when a permit expires, the company gives a 180-day notice, and they begin to work with the agency to begin to reestablish a new permit.
Are operating under a technically expired permit right now?
The permit legally is legitimate until we provide the next permit.
So what's the point of having an expiration date?
Yeah. Maybe I could have one of my staff talk about some of the rules governing the permitting process.
Good afternoon. My name is Sheila Holman. I'm the Assistant Secretary for the Environment. Sorry. Is this better? I'm Sheila Holman. I'm the Assistant Secretary for the Environment. Large permits like the NPDES, the non-point discharge permits, those have expiration dates, and that's set by the Clean Water Act. The point is every, say, 5 years, companies need to come back in with a new application and look at anything that's changed, any new discharges for regulated pollutants. So there is a permit shield, if you will. So if the company comes in with that permit application at least 6 months before the expiration date, they can continue to operate under the existing permit while the agency reviews all the information. And so we're in the process now, as Secretary Regan said, of evaluating that new application. And obviously with this new information, we need to consider what, if any, additional changes need to be made to the permit before issuing a new permit.
Any other questions?
Yes, are you satisfied with the CFPUA's response after the study came out, with the information that you were given, that you heard from what the board members were given? Are you satisfied with that response, 601?
I think that the CFPUA is in the business of testing and ensuring water quality pursuant to what the law requires them to test for. They can't test for things they don't know about. And they have an outstanding history of providing safe drinking water to our community. I will also say, however, that I am not satisfied with the timing of releasing it to our board, to our staff, to the health department. And I know that it may not have been an intentional act on their part. I know they were participating in a study from what they've told us. I would encourage them respectfully in the future to be much more forthcoming, because as this lady's poster right here on the front row indicates, water is the first priority of our civilization, followed by food and shelter. And any and all information related to its purity and its quality, whether it's good or bad, should be in the public domain as soon as it is known. Any other questions?
I have a question. This may be for the—
What's your name, ma'am?
Christina Haley O'Neill, with Great Public Business Journal. And this may be a question for the environmental folks. Not to take the spotlight off of Gen X or Chemours, but is there any research ongoing to find any other emerging compounds, whether it be chemical or microbial, in our water systems? Have any been found?
So the question is, are there efforts to look at waters or other compounds in the waters? And the answer is yes, and it's a combination. A lot with EPA. Obviously, EPA is in charge of setting those national standards. And so they're looking at all of those prevalent pollutants as well as the toxicity of those pollutants to determine what the highest priority should be, what is the greatest public health risk, as they use their resources to establish new standards. Once there are new standards, then the state agencies would then incorporate those new standards into the discharge permits. We're dealing with a few other unregulated pollutants right now, and working with EPA to obviously look at the health studies and also determine how best to move forward with addressing those pollutants.
How many?
There are a variety of pollutants. I don't have a number for you right now.
But is it found directly from our source, the Cape Fear River?
I don't have that number with me. I can get that for you.
Okay, and how many of them present any sort of risk to human health?
I don't have all the details on that pollutant. We've been focused very much on Gen X over the last few days, but I can certainly follow up.
Specifically about Gen X, in your ongoing efforts to look for it, are you planning on, or have you already looked at groundwater?
Yes, we will be testing a couple of the groundwater wells as part of this study. There's also groundwater testing at the facility.
At this time, due to scheduling and others, unless there are other questions, we're going to...
Question right here. There are many questions here.
Jordan, yes.
Who or what agency has the power now to shut down the plant? And also, to the layman, who's not an expert, what would you say to you guys who don't know the effects right now, yet it's still being allowed to continue? That doesn't make sense to most people. You're not sure what the effects are yet. Chemours is still allowed to distribute the chemicals.
Well, the state epidemiologist just had some comments on whether or not it poses a health risk, and I'll defer to him and his comments for answering that part of your question. The first part of your question really relates, in my view, to a national debate that's going on right now about what the federal government should and shouldn't do, what extent, if any, should the EPA exist. Those are legitimate questions that are being posed. And I think if there's ever a better example, post in a Flint, Michigan world as to the efficacy and need for an environmental protection agency, this is it.
Sorry, I lived there for 5 years.
I will recognize and suggest how thankful I am that representatives from David Rouser's office, Tom Tillis's office, and Richard Burr's office are here today. They have the unique position as legislators in the United States Congress to clear up what appears to us an odd policy position of regulated it on one side of the balance sheet and not on the other. Doesn't make sense. And so to the extent that they are able to ask probing questions of the administrator of EPA and his staff, I encourage them to do that. I know they're actively engaged. All three of their offices have reached out to his office. I'm not privy to what conversations might be taking place, but what the content of the conversations are, but I know they are taking place.
To confirm, you're saying that EPA is the final body that has the power to close down production?
Yes. Well, the first body that has the power to close down production is Chemours, and we've asked them to do that until these questions are answered. Well, we've demanded, asked, suggested strongly, because there's nothing more fundamental than water. We all agree to that. Yes, sir.
Michael Pratt, Port City Daily. Is it? Can you, in good conscience, say to the residents that it is safe to drink the water right now, or is that still? I mean, can you say yes or no? Residents should drink the water.
Every question that's been asked today has been an important and probative question, but that's the best one. And that question is what has been posed to me and everyone else up here hundreds of times over the last 7 days. Is our water safe? It's a yes or no question. I asked the company that in a phone call on Monday. They were very gracious with their time, but it took them about a minute and a half to answer the question. At the end of their answer, I said, ma'am, it's a yes or no question. Now, what I'm going to say speaks for myself. I think day-to-day life is fraught with all kinds of risks on the roadway, and as it was pointed out in the meeting, and the Brussels sprouts that we cook in a pan creates carcinogens. There's risk associated with eating cereal and everything else in life. I think as we balance what we know now, I'm drinking the water, my family's drinking the water. I think it's safe. I've made that decision for myself and my family. But I have, obviously, we all have a lot of unanswered questions, and we're thankful that the state regulators are going to insist on getting these answers on their website and divulging the information as quickly as we can get it.
Brussels sprouts don't kill anybody.
That was not my anecdote. I'm simply reporting the story. Are there any other questions?
Magazine. This is to the board members of the Cape Fear Public Utility Authority.
They have indicated they are not participating in this press conference.
Did they tell you why?
No.
But I'm going to ask them how and why they came to the decision to increase the rates yesterday morning amidst this water crisis, and if that sends the right message to their customers.
It sends the wrong message to the community to raise rates at a time when this community has unanswered questions about the water. That's not CFPUA's fault, in my personal opinion, but raising rates at this time, in my opinion, was absolutely the wrong message to send in this community. Thank you all very much.